We have discussed previous class fragmentation. Fragmentation we have discussed, and fragmentation means dividing the packets into several packets, and when these packets are leaving this particular network, again these are going to be reassembled and the sent to the channel. Again, when it goes to the next network, according to the size of that network, again it is going to be fragmented and reassembled like this. This is one kind. This kind of fragmentation called transparent fragmentation. In non-transparent fragmentation, there is no reassemble. These fragmented packets are sent to this one. Okay, this is now packet fragmentation. Here see, this is a fragmentation when the elementary data size is 1 byte. Okay, original packet containing 10 data bytes. This 10 data bytes, A, B, C, D up to J. So what is this packet number? Packet number and number of the first elementary fragment in this packet, 0, and end of the packet bit is 1. So this is, every packet is having header. So these three fields, it is consisting of three fields. What is this? Packet number and number of the first elementary fragment in the in this packet and end of the packet. So here these are the 10 data. This is another kind. This is a header and this is another type. Okay, so here it is 8, means 8, number of the first elementary fragment in this packet is 8 here, and here it is 0. Okay, so with the maximum packet size of 8 payload bytes plus header, 8 payload bytes plus header. So these are various kinds of other packets. Okay, size 5 gateway. Okay, this is 5 and this is again 8. Okay, this is packet with length. And this is packet, this router can accept packet with length of 1200. This router can accept packet with 1400. So means according the destination address is 900 packet. So according to that, these are going to be fragmented. Suppose if a packet length is 3000 is coming to this, this router, then that is going to be fragmented by 1400, 1400. Okay, like this. So it depends on the, then when it is coming to here, this will accept 1200 only, but this network can accept 900. So, but that 1200 again, it is going to be fragmented into minimum 2 packets. Okay, these are the network layer principles. Make sure it works, keep it simple, make clear choices, exploit modularity, expect heterogeneity. So these are the network layer principles. Avoid static options and parameters. Look for good design, not perfect. Strict sending and tolerant receiving. Think about scalability. Consider performance and cost. These are the some of the network layer principles. What it is, make sure it works. Whenever you design any principle or protocol architecture, make sure that it has to work. If it is not working, then what is the use? Keep it simple, because this is a layered architecture, 5 layer or 6 layer or 7 layer, whatever it is, then keep it simple. Okay, there is not much complex. Suppose if it takes complex operations, then automatically the throughput and delay, all these are going to be throughput is reducing, delay is increasing. If the process means operation, protocol operations are not simple. Make clear choices, it should be clear, and exploit modularity. So modularity principle will be available, means every layer is having, you can design a modular, because here software architecture is there, software TCP IP, both software as well as hardware. Expect heterogeneity. If there is an heterogeneity, why it is heterogeneity? Because network means it is connecting different places, different places, those who are using communication devices. Heterogeneity means all of them need not purchase same kind of computers. Okay, so So they have, they can purchase different different kinds of communication devices. Then your protocol architecture should support heterogeneity. Otherwise, it is very much difficult if it is not supporting heterogeneity. Okay, avoid static options and parameters. So because your requirement is increasing. For example, now this pandemic situation, our bandwidth requirement has been increased a lot. If we do not have such kind of network capacity, then we are going to be facing a problem. Okay, because now all the lectures are in online. Previously, 1 year back, it is not like that. Means less speed networks are also sufficient. So then organizations should not think the network capacity is static. That should be in dynamic according to the requirement. Okay, look for good design, not perfect. Okay, if any design is not perfect, it has to be optimized always based on the circumstances and conditions, requirements. Okay, there is no perfect design. Always you keep on optimizing. Strict sending, tolerant receiving. Okay, you have to, whenever strict sending means whenever the station ready to send, it has to send. There should not be delay in sending. If it is delay in sending, then there is obviously delay in receiving also. That's why whenever a station is ready to send packets or frames or data, whatever it is, information, it has to send. The tolerant receiving. So receiver has to be tolerant for faults. There are several faults may occur in between hop to hop. And think about the scalability. So now the network should be scalable. Why it is scalable? If it is an ad hoc network or a fixed network, always the network size is increasing, not decreasing, because of the rapid demand. Any organization you take, you know, network size always it is increasing only, not decreasing. Decreasing when if the organization is closed, then network is also closed. But there is no question of decreasing in a organization, any kind of enterprise. Okay, consider performance and cost. Now we have to think about the network performance and cost. We have always, our network has to be efficient and with the less cost, and quality of service should be provided always. Okay, these are the network layer principles. Any network layer has to be follow all these 10 principles. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And the network layer in the internet. Now, mainly in the internet, a network layer has to play a key role. Why network layer is playing the key role? Because the network layer provides the end-to-end communication. Okay. So without the network layer, there is no internet actually. So main functionality of the internet is main component in the internet is network layer. So otherwise, without a network layer, you cannot connect to the end system, no, the another system. So that's why network layer play a key role. Okay, the IP version 4 protocol. As of now, we are using IP version 4 protocol. You know, I think 4 is a version, and IP addresses every device in the internet is uniquely identified by IP address. Okay, you know about this, I think. Huh? Every network, it is IP is a 4 bytes, no. And IP version 6, if 4 bytes address is not sufficient because of IoT, Internet of Things, so many devices are going to be connected day by day in the internet. You can see there 10, 15 years back, even hardly nobody, every user is hardly using mobile devices. Nowadays, every home is connected with minimum 4 to 6 devices, okay, internet devices. Now, similarly, after 10 years, if every person can have minimum 10 to 15 of internet devices, okay? So in that case, the existing IP version 4 protocol is not sufficient to connect so many devices. That's why IP version 6 is coming, but it is not practically implementable. Somewhere it is going to be is implementable because nowadays all the devices are not going to support IP version 6, but in future, every device should support IP version 6 only. Because of rapid increasing in the internet. So internet connect control protocols. So these are the protocols, IP protocols, label switching, MPLS, OSPF, internet gateway routing protocol, BGP, gateway routing protocol, internet multicasting, and mobile IP. So these are the things related to internet. Okay, some of the protocols. These are the protocols. These are the protocols, and internet multicasting and mobile IP and addresses. See, this is a typical internet because internet means it is connection of several networks. So this is one kind of network, and this is home network. Your home computer is also connected to the internet. But how it is connected to the internet through some telephone cable or whatever it is, telephone cable or any internet service provider, then it is connecting to regional network. This is connected to other network. This is connected like this. It's globe internet. So this is company network, and this is IP router. This is, for example, university or company. So every company is having its own router. That router is connected to national network like this. So this is your laptop is connected to a mobile network. This is a WiMAX something. So this is the internet is an interconnected collection of many networks. Internet means connected collection of many networks, because these are not homogeneous. European backbone network is some kind of network, and this is a US backbone network is another kind of network. This mobile network is another heterogeneous. There is no homogeneity here. All these are following different packet sizes, and fragmentation, defragmentation is required, either transparent or non-transparent. Okay, are you following?
Yes, sir.
If you have any doubts, you can ask. I'm going to complete actually network layer. Now IP version 4 protocol. This exactly we are using now, 32 bits, 4 bytes I said. So the 4 bytes are like this. Okay, version, header length, differentiated service, total length. So every field is having its own importance. Okay, header checksum, source address, destination address. Source address, destination address is most important. Source address means which node is sending, and destination address to whom you are sending. Okay, to whom you are sending. These two fields has to be decided by the sender. Okay, and header checksum. This is destination address. Actually, sometimes it is not perfect. You can send it to the nearby node, and the nearby node again it is sending like that. Okay. Options. IP version 4 security options. Specify how secret the datagram is. Here we discussed datagram approach and connection oriented connection. Two types of services network. Very beginning we have discussed. One is datagram. Another one is connection oriented. In a connection oriented, if there is a virtual circuit, then it is a connection oriented. Otherwise, it is a datagram approach. So security specifies how secret the datagram is. Strict source routing gives some complete path to be followed. Loose source routing gives a list of routers not to be missed. Record route makes each router append its IP addresses. Timestamp makes each router append its addresses and timestamp. Okay, so these are the some of the options and descriptions. Okay, some of the IP options, internet protocol options. So these, I think here options field is there here, maybe somewhere you can see this option field. It's there, I think. And here IP address, 32 bits, network and host. So here network address is there and host address is there out of this. Okay, so that network address is divided in, suppose 3 bytes divided into network, and 1 byte is host. Okay, how many hosts are possible here? For example, 1 byte, 2 to the power of 8, so 256 hosts are possible. So like that, how many networks are possible? Then 2 to the power of 3 bytes, 2 to the power of 24. Okay, this we can call it as a subnet mask. The network address we can call it as a subnet mask. Okay, this is class A, class B, class C, class D networks. It's divided. See, this is okay. So these are the different kinds of networks, and they are using like this subnet to the internet, splitting IP address into separate networks with the subnetting. Okay, university first address, last address, how many networks this is, and this is prefix. Okay. Every university is having their networks is having their own prefix like this, the subnet mask. Okay, yeah, these are the network and its subnet mask by 19, 3 prefixes, 21.20/22. Okay. This one is a network address actually. So how many networks are possible here? Here, this is the network address, subnet mask. Subnet mask. Okay. IP addresses. See, I told now. If you want, you can note down. This is most important actually. Class A, Class B, Class C, Class D, Class E for identification purpose. You can note down this. Class A addresses are these many. Class B addresses are these many. Class C, these many. Class D is range for host address. This is host. So number of hosts are more in Class A. Number of hosts are very less in Class C. And this is multicast address. Okay, this multicast means for specific number of users you can multicasting. Here networks are more. Here networks are more. Hosts are less. This is important. A means the first bit is zero. How many bytes for the host? 3. How many bytes for the network? 1. 2. 2 bytes for network. 3 bytes for network. And 1 byte for host. Like this. This is most important. If by seeing the IP address, you have to tell that belongs to which class. That IP address belongs to which class. Special IP addresses. These are some of the special IP addresses. Suppose this host means your network means you have established your own self network. So that address is this. This is about the IP addresses. There is another address. We can call it as a port address. IP address and port address is different. The IP address is 4 bytes and port address is like this. It is a number, okay? 4-digit number. So what is meant by this port address? Port address tells that application address, application. So means in a computer, we can run the several applications. You can open several browsers. Yahoo, you can open. Rediff, you can open. Gmail, you can open. Or any other web page, you can open. But your system IP address is same. For every application, there is a port address. Okay, are you identifying? So this router is communicating with your machine. So suppose if you have opened a Yahoo message, means the reply will come to Yahoo Mail. You have opened Gmail. Gmail has to come to Gmail only. But IP address is same. Port address is different. So once the packet comes to here, then this machine can classify that information has to go in which port. Okay, the port address I have identified. This is actually TCP layer. Address, TCP address, transport layer address. There are 3 layers, no? MAC layer, network layer, and transport layer. So MAC layer address, MAC address, and MAC address means it can identify this device. Okay, it can identify your local device. IP address means this nearest router IP address. Okay, means logically, it's not physically. Okay, this nearest router will maintain there is a mapping between the MAC address and IP address. Because IP addresses are very fixed, not equivalent to the mobile devices. Okay, how many devices? So many devices are there. Millions of devices are there, but millions of IP addresses are not possible. It is only 4 bytes. So, but how this will be there? But it is not a logical address, and there is a mapping between physical address and logical address. Your machine is connected to nearest internet, nearest router. This router will maintain the mapping between the IP address and this MAC address. For example, if you consider our university, so our university, how many IP addresses are there? Hardly we have 12, 13 or maximum 18 IP addresses are there. But how many users, how many devices, network devices? Every student is having its own mobile and every computers are there. Okay, like that around 4,000, 5,000 devices are there, but 4,000, 5,000 IP addresses are not there in the campus. Only 18 addresses are there. These 18 addresses can map to these 4,000 devices or 5,000 devices, whatever it is. So every device is having its MAC address. That is unique. Your MAC address is unique. Your laptop is having own unique MAC address, and your mobile is having unique MAC address, but unique, not IP address. When you connected to the IP address, then your mobile is getting an IP address. That is not permanent. That is a temporary. When you use the internet, that IP address is work. When you again disconnected, that IP address is not valid to your machine or your mobile. But MAC address is valid permanently. Are you following now? Are you following?
Yes, sir.
What is the difference between MAC address, IP address, and port address? Three types of addresses are there.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how these are going to be used? One, while you are sending the information and receiving the information. MAC address is unique for the device. IP address is logical address as and demand. Okay. Port address is application address. Okay. You a machine or a mobile or whatever it is. You can open a railway reservation. You can open bus reservation. Any number of sites you can open. Okay. And now you are using Google Meet class. That is an IP address. That is a port address. My data is coming to that particular port. Simultaneously, you can do email, check email also. Are you checking? Also, you can do whatever you want, because I am not seeing. So all these are using different port addresses. Different port addresses. With we are established a communication. That is a particular port. You are checking an email. That is again a port. Okay, you are receiving that information from the internet only. My information, my audio is also, video is also, you are getting through internet only. But that is a different port, and this is a different. This is a port address like that. Okay, in this some reserved ports are there, and FTP, for example, FTP is a file transfer protocol. Then the address is 2122, I think. 21 is for establishing the connection. 22 is for data transfer. So like this, some reserved ports are there, and if user generates some applications, then application. Port address is different. Okay, I think 1064 are port address are there. Okay, and the remaining are user defined ports applications. User can define any number of applications, but every application requires one port address. Okay, this is IP version 6 goals actually. Support billions of hosts, reducing routing table size, simplify protocols, better security, attention to type of service. Aid multicasting, roaming host without changing addresses, allow future protocol evaluation, permit coexistence of old new protocols. So these are some of the goals of IPv6. Actually, IPv6 is about to start, or some places already it is started. What are the goals? Support billions of hosts. IPv4 is not sufficient. I am saying logical address, but the logical addresses are also. It's not possible. Our university is having only 18 addresses. We are trying for getting more IP addresses, but it is not possible. There is a very shortage of in IPv4 addresses. It's not so easy task to get the IPv4 because lot of demand is there for internet. Okay, it's not easily you are not going to get IPv4 address. That's why market is looking for technology is looking for IPv version 6, but the what is the problem with IPv6? IPv6, if the all devices are IPv6, then previous devices are IPv4. Now, if you purchase a laptop or a mobile, if it supports IPv6, then there is a mapping. There means heterogeneity will come. How the IP? Suppose if you should always get the information from IPv6 only. But everybody has to change, need not change, you know, everybody changing means it is very much difficult. All our computers are IPv4. If all of a sudden, if I say you remove your laptop and take IPv6, why do you purchase it? It's very ridiculous. So that's why slowly the market is converting into IPv6. Okay, what is the main goal of IPv6? Support billions of hosts. Okay, oh, it supports reduce routing table size. It has to reduce routing table. And simplify the protocol. So simplify the protocols, better security. It has to give some better security, attention to type of services. multicasting, it has to support roaming host without changing, and mainly integration with the existing networks IPv6 4. So this is the IPv6 header. Previously we have discussed IPv4, now this is IPv6. So here you see source address 16 bytes, destination address 16 bytes, there 4 bytes. Okay, and this is about the extension headers, hop to hop options, destination options, routing, fragmentation, authentication, and encrypted security payloads. So this is IPv6 extension headers. Okay, this is the hop by hop extension header for large datagrams. Okay, and this is IPv version 6. Next header extension length, routing type, and segments left, a type of specific data. You can go through this: message type, destination, unreachable, description, packet could not be delivered, time exceeded, time to leave field hit 0. Okay, suppose sometimes the packet may goes to in infinite loop, so that's why time that is going to be discarded. Parameter problem, invalid header field, source quench, stop packet, redirect. Okay, these are the some of the message types and descriptions. Okay, internet control protocols, this is ethernet switch and this is a router, because this is a LAN, so LAN, and these two LANs are connected by the internet. Okay, you can see this frame, host 1 to 2, host 1 to 2 frame. Okay, so source IP address IP1, like this. So these are the routing tables. Actually these are the routing tables, two switched ethernet LAN joined by a router, and this is a label switching MPLS. Okay, so you can go through this. This is OSPF internet, open source shortest path. These are the routing, very basic old internet protocols. Okay, these are the OSPF is a internet gateway routing protocol. So five type of messages: hello, link state update, link state acknowledgement, data base description, link state. Link state routing already we have discussed, na? So it's OSPF is a routing protocol. So hello message is going to be sent, link state update is going to be sent, link state acknowledgement. These two are there, na? Link state that already we have discussed. And BGP, border gateway protocol. Examples of routing constraints: no commercial traffic for EduCAT network, never put IRAC on route starting at Pentagon, choose a cheaper network, choose a better performing network, don't go for Apple to Google to Apple. See, these are some of the exterior gateway routing protocol examples of routing constraints. Okay, these are some of the constraints. Okay, BGP exterior gateway routing protocol, BGP routing. See, these are the border gateway routing protocols. Means at borders gateway, this is a border gateway, how this protocol will work. Okay, once if within the network some kind of protocols is there, that is OSPF. And border gateway protocol means it can decide, this gateway protocol can decide the packet is belongs to which LAN, okay, which network. See, this is autonomous network. How many 4 networks are there? Actually the packets are moving between these 4 networks. BGP will decide, border gateway protocol will be decide that particular packet is belongs to which network, which autonomous network. Okay, so that is based on these transit routing policy, transit and customer and P. Okay, the exterior gateway routing protocols, this propagating of BGP router advertisement. Okay, these are some of the advertisements, means where the packet is belongs to. Yeah, this is mobile IP. This is about what we have discussed, OSPF and BGP are internet gateway protocols. Okay, internet, these are very old. Actually, if you see, if you want to know the latest, you can search RFC, request for comment. Whatever the protocols are there, no, the text matters. okay, hundreds of pages matter is available on the internet. So RFC means everybody can do research and they can update their protocols in the form of RFC, request for comment. Okay, IETF, Internet Engineering Task Force, is there. So that forum always update these protocols and they keep it in open source. As a open source, anybody can download. Okay, just you can search in a Google OSPF BGP RFC. Okay, just you can search BGP plus RFC, you will get a text. OSPF plus RFC, request for comment, a text file. For example, mobile IP plus RFC. So you will get enormous information, a text file, various versions are available. Okay, you can go through this. So in that, what you will see, you can see the packet formats, okay, and protocol specifications. These two important things, protocol specifications and packet formats. And every field, the packet format in the sense, all the fields are there and the fields meaning will be there. Okay, each and every field. Actually, it is, you should not remember. Those who are doing internally details, you can go through it. But at a higher level, you should know what is what. Okay, if you want to do research on OSPF, then you can download it. If you want to do research on mobile IP, you can download mobile IP RFCs. And from the beginning, you can go through that RFCs, how, so that you could understand how the improvements have been done on that particular protocol. So means you could understand what is the initial stage mobile IP, now mobile IP, what is there, and how many versions are there. Okay. So mobile IP, the main purpose of the mobile IP is, now we are talking about OSPF and BGP for the structured networks. Okay, not moving, the nodes are not moving. So suppose now mobile IP will come for mobile devices, laptops. You are moving from one node to one place to another place, but your device is connecting to the internet. How it is? Okay, how it is going to be connected? Because of mobile IP. IP is different, mobile IP is different. Okay, IP is internet protocol, mobile IP is, it's also mobile internet protocol, means the device is moving. So what are the goals? Mobile hosts use home IP address anywhere. Okay, it is using home IP address. So means, for example, my mobile is there, my SIM card is there, my SIM card is belongs to this district. Okay, so means this state, at least this state. So that is called a home IP address. I'm moving to from here to some Hyderabad. So then it is moving, it's that Hyderabad is not my home address. So but my home IP address is here only. Okay, so then there is a mapping should be required. Whenever my mobile is moving, means I am moving, then it has to be visitor location, that is visitor IP address, not home. I am a visitor to there. Okay, so there must be a mapping between home IP address to visitor IP address. Okay, no software changes to fixed host. Okay, mobile host use home IP address anyway. I have to use my IP address only. Okay, I'm not going to get a new IP address because authentication problems are there. Okay, if you are moving from one place to another place, who will believe blindly? So that's why always your mobile has to use only local IP address, not the visitor IP address. No software changes to fixed host. Okay, software is not going to be changed. No changes to router software tables. Packets for mobile host restrict DTOS and no overhead for mobile. So these are some of the goals. When you are moving from IP to mobile IP, what are the changes? Okay, no software change to fixed host, but fixed host is there. So fixed host is also working mobile IP, but is this software will not be changed. No changes to router software. So sometimes there must be integration is required. I'm moving from one place to another place. I may connect to the fixed network. That fixed network should not use for structured networks one software, for mobile networks another software. This is not possible, na? So single switches can support for mobile or fixed. Okay, if I use Wi-Fi card in my standalone system, I can connect to the access point also, no? So there is no software is required again separate. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Any doubts? When you are moving from mobile IP to IP, what are the goals? The existing underlined hardware, software we have to use. Over it should support mobile devices also. This is what my conclusion. Okay, there are two kinds of networks, structured, unstructured. Initially, we have established for the structured networks only because we don't know, we don't know IP will come, mobile IP will come. In 1980s, 90s, there is no mobile IP. Just we are talking only, it's analog only. But nowadays, mobiles are also, mostly mobiles are using internet rather than laptops and desktops. It's drastically reduced. And now always you are attending my class, I think in mobile only, okay? So you are not using a laptop, but you don't have sometimes. You are not using desktop. Okay, so that's why the existing network should support mobile networks also. That's why mobile IP is there. You are using internet, using your mobile because of mobile IP, not because of IP. Your desktop is using internet because of IP. Okay, this is what, this is about the chapter 5 network layer completed. Any questions? Now, up to this.